Hi, my name is Matt Duff, and we're going to be covering cold junction compensation in this session. So what we learned in the last session is that a thermocouple generates a voltage that is proportional to the difference in temperature between the measurement junction and the reference junction. So in other words, the thermocouple does not give us an absolute temperature reading, it only gives us a relative temperature reading. So since we normally want an absolute temperature reading, what we're going to do is we're going to put a temp sensor right next to our reference junction. So I put my temp sensor here, and I make sure that it's at the same temperature as my reference junction. And this way, what I do is I get an absolute reading with this temperature sensor, and then I use my relative reading between the two junctions I combine that information to get finally an absolute temperature reading on my measurement junction. And this is called cold junction compensation or reference junction compensation. So often in the past, this junction was normally the colder part, and then my measurement junction, I was trying to measure something really hot, and so this is normally called the cold junction. But we're using the nomenclature measurement junction and reference junction here to drive home the point that it is quite possible with the thermocouple to measure a cold temperature here. So for example, you can do cryogenics, but that's the name has kind of stuck as cold junction compensation. So you can use a variety of different temperature sensors here. So for example, we have a part that's recently released called the ADT7320, which is a very accurate IC temperature sensor. So you could use that for this. Another series of parts that we have is called the AD8494 through the AD8497. And these parts include both the temperature sensor and the instrumentation amplifier that we use to measure this tiny voltage. And that's what we're going to cover in the next session.